everyone. This is Palak Lohade and today I'll be talking about 7 cardinal principles of homeopathy. In short, I'm not going to go brief into it. So let's quickly go into the topic. So the 7 cardinal principles of homeopathy are the pillar of homeopathic system of medicine on which entire homeopathic system is based upon. They are as follows. Number 1, the law of similars. Number 2, the law of semplex. Number 3, the law of minimum dose. Number 4, the principle of drug proving. Number 5, the principle of drug dynamization. Number 6, the principle of vital force. Number 6, that the last one, the principle of chronic disease. So the very first law is law of similars. That we all know that like cures like, which is similia similibus curantur, which states that a drug capable of producing in a healthy individual a diseased state exactly similar to that happens in a diseased individual acts as a curative agent if the disease is in curable state. Second, the law of simplex. Giving single simple medicine to a patient at a time is called law of simplex. Third one is the law of minimum dose. The dose should be so minimum so to arouse a vitality in a diseased individual is called as law of minimum dose. The fourth principle is the principle of drug proving. Drug proving is a process of ascertaining out the disease producing power or a curative power of a drug by administering it on a healthy human beings of both sexes, different age group, and on different constitutions. Fifth, the principle of drug dynamization. It is a mathematico-mechanical process by which latent curative medicinal properties of drug substance are brought into activity. There are two methods of drug dynamization. The first one is trituration for solid and the second one is succussion for liquid. Sixth, the principle of vital force. The entire concept of homeopathy is fruitless without vital force. Hahnemann was of belief that it was this very force which was spirit-like and dynamic in nature which animates the human body. While this vital force running a harmonious course in a body of a person, then he is said to be in a state of a health. But if it is deranged by miasms, agents like miasm, then the person is said to be in a state of a disease. And when the vital force leaves the body, then the person is said to be dead. The seventh, the last one, the principle of chronic disease. Hahnemann, after the birth of homeopathy, Hahnemann was successfully practicing homeopathy when suddenly he noticed certain condition which had tendency to relapse. No matter what the medicine was administered, the patient would come back with the same complaint. After looking through so many points, Hahnemann came to the conclusion that chronic disease were due to miasms. The miasm is a noxious agent which is dynamic in nature and which has capacity to produce disease. The chronic miasms are divided into 3, the psora, syphilis and psychosis. The miasm is said to be the fundamental cause of all diseases. So we have done with all the 7 cardinal principles, that is the law of similars, the law of simplex, the law of minimum dose, the principle of drug proving, the principle of drug dynamization, the principle of vital force, and the last, the principle of chronic disease. Thank you.